Welcome back, Happy Fabricators. In this video, we're going to be doing part two of the cheap welding fixture table build. Now, if you didn't see part one, check that out down in the description below. Now, thanks for all the love in the last video. We had over 50 people comment and say that we should definitely continue with the idea of making a belt sander with the remaining components of this table. So we're going to have to see if we can't make that happen. But in this video, we are going to continue to build this table out. First off, we're going to build a stand for this thing, and then we might try to elaborate on that and make some other built-in components that could be useful for fabricating. Okay, so first off, we're going to build this like we don't have a welding table to start with. So I'm not going to use my other welding table over there. I've got this thing set up on sawhorses, which, I mean, you could use it just like this just as well. But we're going to build a stand that could potentially fold up with some casters on it so we can move this thing around and be just a little more versatile. Let's get started. Okay, so as you've seen just a bit ago, I was using this fireball square to get my first part of my leg frame tacked up, but I want to show just another way that you can utilize this table, much in the same way that you use these squares. The great thing about these squares is you can clamp them in three separate planes. You can have your angles and then your flat dimension and clamp it all down and get it square. We can use this table in a very similar way. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take and we're going to clamp a piece of flat bar or tubing. Actually, I've got a piece of tubing here. I don't know why I said flat bar. And we're going to clamp this on the bottom of the table. And this is going to give us our flat plane. Then the two pieces, miters that I need to weld together here, I can set this guy right up against the flat of the table here, just like this. Make sure the throat of my miter is right in the corner and clamp that down. Now I know that we are flat and our yaw is flat. We can slide our other piece up against here and do the same thing. You could even run your piece across there or clamp it down to your lower piece of material depending on how specific you need to go. Now this thing's fixtured up and we're ready to weld it out. Okay, so now we've got some semblance of folding legs here. We've just got to figure out some way to lock them together. So we're going to flip this guy over and figure out a kind of modular way to keep these guys from coming in on each other. But so far I like it. Folds up nice and tight, and this should fit in the back of my pickup. And here we have it. We have legs on our budget DIY fixture table. I've actually got to use this thing on a couple of projects and I've really liked it. The couple things that have stood out to me the most is, might be just me, but I feel like the BBs that come off your MIG welding don't adhere to the table as well. My other table, I spent a lot of time scraping those BBs off, and I feel like these ones, sometimes you still have to scrape them off, but I feel like they're not as stuck to the table, which is nice. Another feature that I really like is just the combination of having a smooth surface and then the open webbing. It just really opens it up so that you have that great diversity of being able to have a flat space and work on a small project and not have it roll off into holes around the ground. But then you also have the ability to integrate those clamps and be able to clamp larger stuff down. I feel like it's kind of a good happy medium. The other thing that I thought was really cool that I found myself doing with a couple projects that I've already done on this table is these grooves here. I don't know about you, but me, I find myself, whenever you got a corner joint and you're welding the inside of that corner joint or the outside, sometimes if you want to finish that corner joint out, you end up getting a little bit of weld or booger on your table. And what I found that these grooves are really nice for is once I got everything tacked and fixtured down, I was able to maneuver those welds over these little crevasses here and be able to make a full pass down on the weld and not have to worry about welding it to my table, which is kind of cool just to have that little bit of versatility and open spaces to be able to do that. So I don't necessarily recommend doing the folding table like I did here. I did it because I want to be able to use it for some mobile applications. It might be better, depending on what you use, just to make a solid platform, but I really like it. We set it on some casters. I've got a really rough floor in here, obviously, but she spins around real nicely. And currently I've got it so that it just bolts together on the bottom here, and that's what keeps it from collapsing on me. So I got to pull four bolts and the thing folds up for me and nice and compact. And then I also offset my little foot plates down here so that I could kind of suck up to it and be able to not be hitting my feet down here on those. So I put one closer to the center and then the other one on the back. So that's something to consider even if you are building a more permanent one, is to kind of leave that more open. I know I didn't do that on my other table over there and I regret it. Now we're definitely gonna have to build that belt sander. There was an overwhelming amount of you guys that commented and it was awesome to see. So I guess I'm gonna have to figure out how we're gonna do that budget belt sander with our leftover parts from our table saw. Definitely stick around. We're gonna have multiple more episodes on this. We've got some ideas for different types of clamping fixtures, more storage, and just other things to overall improve your welding table on a budget. So once again, thanks for watching AM Custom Fab. If you wanna see more fabrication content, make sure to click some of the links that are gonna pop up here. If you wanna be notified of upcoming videos, hit that subscribe button. It's free to do so, and go build something, guys.